Okay, now look at question number 21 from chapter number 32 of H.C. Verma. Consider N equal to N1, N2, identical cells, each of EMF E and internal resistance R. Suppose N1 cells are joined in series to form a line and N2 such lines are connected in parallel. The combination drives the current and an external resistance R. Find the current. Okay. So, first of all, we have got a single battery. I have one single battery over here of EMF E and resistance R. Now, N1 such batteries have been connected in series. Okay. N1 such batteries have been connected in series. I have got N1 such batteries. So, if I want to combine them into a single battery, that single battery should have EMF how much? The EMF of the single battery will be N times E and the resistance will be N times R. Because all the EMFs are in series, so the EMF get added. All the resistors are in series, so the resistors get added. Okay. Now, these batteries are connected in parallel. Okay. How many such batteries are connected in parallel? N2. N2 such batteries have been connected in parallel. Okay. So, like this. So, I have got N2 such batteries. Actually, I should write N1 over here. I made a mistake. This will be N1. Okay. N1 into R, N1 into E. And here I have got N2 such batteries. So, when I want to again convert them into one single equivalent battery, okay, what should be the EMF of that battery? So, there's a formula for parallel combination. I'm not going into the formula. You can look it up anywhere. Okay. The formula gives me that the net EMF over here will be N1E, while the resistance will be N1R by N2. Okay. N1E is the EMF, N1R by N2 is the resistance. Okay. But since N equal to N1, N2, I could write N2 as N by N1. So I could write down my internal resistance as N1 square R by capital N. Okay. Now, this battery has been connected to an external resistor, correct? The combination drives a current and an external resistance R, and we have to find that current. So, that's very easy part. Okay. So, I just take this battery. Okay. Put it with a resistor in series. So, this is my external resistor. Okay. R. Here I have N1E EMF and here I have N1 square R by N. This is the internal resistance. So the current I in the circuit will be how much? I will be total EMF N1E divided by total resistance. So R plus N1 square R by capital N. So we solved the part A of the question. Now, what is the part B asking? Assuming that N1 and N2 can be continuously varied, find the relation between N1, N2, R and small r for which the current in R is maximum. So, we have found this current. Now, we have to find the condition for the current to be maximum. Okay, how will that happen? See, in this formula, EMF is constant, R is constant, small r and capital N are constant. The only variable is N1. So, for maximum current, all I have to do is differentiate I with N1 and make it equal to 0. This gives me maxima or minima, but since the question is asking maxima, so obviously this should give me a maxima situation. Okay, so I will not check for the double derivative. I'll just put the single derivative and write the condition as having maxima. Okay, so I just need to differentiate the function I over here. Okay. So when you differentiate this with N1, what do you get? You will get R plus N1 square R by N times E minus N1E 2 N1 R by N divided by R plus N1 square R by N whole square, and I want to make this equal to 0. So, take this on the other side, it becomes 0. this difference should be equal to 0. That means this function should be equal to this function. So I have r plus n1 square r by n times e should be equal to n1e times 2n1. So I'll write this n1 square 2e n1 square r by n. Let's move e over here. It's not needed. Okay. So r is equal to n1 square r by n. You could have obtained this condition directly using the maximum power transfer theorem, where the current through the external resistor is maximum when it is equal to internal resistor, right? So this is the condition, okay, for the current to be maximum. Or I could rewrite this as r equal to n1 r by n2. Okay, so this is the relation that we are looking for. This is the answer.